God, praise God. We'd like to welcome each and every one of you to our prayer line this Friday night. Welcome wherever you are listening to us from, in Europe, in America, in Africa, in East Asia. We just say welcome. Tonight we're going to have a very special prayer based on some utterances that Jesus Christ made just before he gave up the ghost. You're going to be blessed tonight. Please call a friend, call a neighbor, and tell them to listen to us and join us so they can be blessed also, as we believe we are going to be blessed. Tonight is a very special night. Like we always have done all week long, we're going to listen to some old Black old school gospel music. And I've always said, you don't hear this kind of music in today. Things have changed, but this still stands the test of time. We're going to go to Albertina Walker tonight and let this specially blessed lady be a blessing to us. He keeps on blessing me. It's the first selection for tonight. Please enjoy it. Come on now.
He keeps on blessing me.
Yeah.
Over and over again.
Over and over again.
Going out and coming in.
He keeps on blessing me. He keeps on blessing me. I know I don't deserve all the good things that he's done, but it keeps right on. He keeps right on. He keeps right on blessing me.
He keeps on making a way.
Right on.
Making a way.
Making a way.
Making a way.
now.
Hallelujah.
Ah.
Glory. You see, I've been singing my praises up. And somebody said, when you sing your praises up, the blessings will come down.
Albertina Walker, he keeps right on blessing me. Trouble in my way. Come on now.
Trouble in my way.
Trouble in my way.
I've had to cry some time.
I had to cry some time.
Trouble.
Trouble in my way.
Made me cry some time.
I had to cry some time.
A little weak at night.
A little weak at night.
That's all right.
That's all right.
Jesus,
he will fix it.
After
a while,
trouble in my way.
Trouble in my way.
Made me cry so many times.
I some time.
So
trouble
much trouble.
In my way.
I've had to cry some time. A little wake at night.
A little wake at night.
But that's all right.
That's all right.
Jesus,
he will fix it.
After a while. Stepped in the front.
Stepped in the front.
Long time ago. With Shadrach and
Meshach.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Minister Mike. Thank you, Minister Mike. God bless you, sir. We appreciate all you do for the kingdom. Hallelujah. We want to thank Albertina Walker for taking us on the podcast to the prayers for tonight. Hallelujah. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Everyone everywhere, thank you so much for joining us tonight. Thank you for always making it a point to be here with us, even as we pray together and as we reach out to the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings, expecting Him to do great things for us tonight. I want to give honor to all my elders, I want to give honor to all my pastors. I want to give honor to all my deacons, all my deaconesses. I thank God for each and every one of you, all my church workers. I bless the name of the Lord for you. And of course, all our members from New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and the New York areas, and all our friends all across the United States, from Canada to Louisiana, from North Carolina to California, we'd like to thank you for joining us tonight. I want to especially thank those who are listening to us on the podcast. But before I do that, I want to give honor to all the ministers, all the men and women of God who are laboring in the vineyard, both in Fresh Anointing and outside Fresh Anointing, that are so humble to be on this prayer line. I really, really admire your humility, because by your own right, there's nothing I'm doing on this prayer line that you cannot do. But you've chosen to sit down and pray for me and pray with me. I really do appreciate you for that. And for all our friends across the world that listen to us on the podcast, I thank you for joining us tonight. More than 27 countries, my last count. And tonight, for sure, we will cross the 6,000 listeners and 6,000 downloads by the time we are done on this prayer line tonight. I checked just before coming here to just see who the top 10 countries are for the last 7 days. The top 10 countries out of those 27 countries. And guess who they are? Nigeria. Always up there. United States. Following after Nigeria in the last 7 days. Followed by United Kingdom. Wow. We have so many people in the United Kingdom listening to us. Followed by Ghana. We bless the name of the Lord for everybody in Ghana that is listening to us. In fact, Ghana and France, they tie. And we thank God for those in France who listen to us. I wish I can speak French. I'm learning it, but I still got a long way to go. Thank you, all the people who reside in France that listen to us. Then after that, the Philippines. We thank God for my friends in the Philippines. I know I invaded the website this past week. I had to talk to the pastor there that it was not intentional. But there you are. From that point on, we've been getting more people listening to the podcast from the Philippines. And I will be with you Sunday morning. Yes. All my friends in Metro Manila and all my friends in the provinces. I feel like mentioning some of your names, but I will not. We're going to be together on Sunday morning at 10 o'clock. That is for sure by the grace of God. So please make a plan to join us. I'll be bringing you a very special message on Sunday morning, which will be Saturday night, my own time in New York. It promises to be a blessed time. We thank God for those from Canada. Philippines is followed by Canada, and after Canada is Sri Lanka. After Sri Lanka is New Zealand. And after New Zealand is Jamaica. Now, those are the 10 that showed up as the top 10. I'm sure following very closely will be Guyana and a couple of other countries that I will not have time to get into tonight. We'd like to know how the podcast and the prayer line are blessing you, please. We would like to know. If this podcast has been a blessing to you, if the prayer line has been a blessing to you, please drop us a note and give us a testimony. The email address is bishop@deliveranceplace.com. Deliverance Place is one word, deliveranceplace.com. bishop@deliveranceplace.com. I like to read from you. I like to hear from you how this podcast and this prayer line has been a blessing to you. If you have a testimony, we'd like to hear your testimony. And if you have one or two things to say, we'll be glad to read. We'll be glad to listen to you. God bless you as you join us tonight. We are going to pray. Father God, we thank you for bringing us together into what we call your house, as necessitated by the pandemic. You are the God of everywhere, and you've assembled us together wherever you've placed us. Tonight is another night that we want to cry unto you. We pray you give us the strength to do so. We pray you give us the anointing to do so. And we pray that by the time we finish, we will have been loaded with blessings from the throne room of God. We thank you, Papa, for answering our prayers tonight. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen and amen and amen. The more I look at the life of Jesus, the more I see so many things worthy of being used as prayer themes. As a matter of fact, if it were possible, we'll just stay with Jesus for the rest of the year, because we cannot exhaust the prayer themes that can be extracted from the words, the walk, and the ways of Jesus. The prayer for tonight is connected with one of the seven sayings on the cross. You remember the seven sayings on the cross that we always talk about during Easter season? My focus today is the third saying on the cross, to be exact. Actually, we can pray about every saying on the cross, but I feel led to take out the third saying on the cross and use that for our prayer tonight. This saying is recorded in the Gospel of John, the 19th chapter, the 26th and the 27th verses. John 19, 26 and 27. I read, "When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple standing by, whom he loved, he said unto his mother, Woman, behold thy son. Then saith he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home." They tell us in Africa that the words of a dying person are very important words. We take them seriously, and we value them above what they spoke when they were alive. I remember when my grandmother was about to die, my father brought a tape recorder and told her to just say whatever she wants to say. And she recorded things that are still available till today after so many years for the whole family. I remember when she died and they were laying her in state, they were playing the things that she said while she laid in state. Africans take the words of a dying person very, very, very important. Major lesson to learn here is this: Jesus specializes in connecting helpers to his people. Did you hear what I said? Jesus specializes in connecting helpers to his people. And he did that with his mom. I'm not even sure his mother knew that she needed a helper at this point, because I'm sure she was engrossed by what was going to happen to her son. But Jesus, who always thinks about tomorrow from today, looked at mommy and said, "When I die, who will take care of this woman? I need to find a helper for my mother." And what he did was classic. He looked among the audience that were there. It's funny though. He never chose any of his siblings. No. He found somebody that he knew he could rely on. He found somebody that he knew his heart was full of love. And he said, John will do it. So he looked at John. And he looked at his mother. And he said, Mother, this your son is dying today. From now on, that guy standing beside you, John, will be your son. And then he looked at John. He said, John, from now on, the woman standing beside you is your mother. And the Bible says there was no argument. The Bible says there was acceptance. And John took the mother of Jesus home. And that was where she stayed. She was cared for the rest of her life. You know what we are going to pray for tonight? You need a helper in your life, whether you admit it or you don't admit it. Every single one of us need helpers in our lives. Now, you can connect yourself to a helper and it may work out or it may not work out. But when God himself divinely connects you to a helper, you know it's going to work out. And that was what Jesus did for mommy. She was connected to John, and there was no failure recorded in the Bible. Until he died, until she died, she was taken care of. 99.99% of the time, God uses people to help us. You can pray as much as you want, but I found out that God himself will not come down to help you. You can fast as much as you want. God is not going to come down to help you. He will take the prayers that you have prayed for help, and it will touch somebody's heart. And it will say, I need you to rise up and help this person. Or he will send you to someone to talk to that person. And before you get there, God will have talked to them. And that's how divine connection is made and you are helped. We all need helpers in our lives, people. I don't care how spiritual you are, and I will prove that to you momentarily. I want you to look into your life for a second. Many of the good things that have happened to you in your life, they are as a result of God connecting you with the right people. There's no doubt about that. I can say that for sure in my own life. I can give you examples upon examples upon examples right here about how God connected me with people that helped me. Many of you have heard me tell the story of how I got a job down south. At South Trust Bank, I actually went out to deliver pizza. And the guy that I delivered pizza to, believe it or not, was the president of a bank. And here was I spent all my life, at least a good deal of my life in Africa, working in the bank. So after giving this guy the pizza, he looked at me and said, you sound like a Nigerian. I said, yes, sir, I'm from there. And then he was telling me he knows quite a few Nigerians that have done business with him. And I didn't know what type of business he did. And I gave him his pizza. He gave me a good tip. And in addition to that, he gave me his business card. And I saw that. It was not only just working in the bank, he was the president of the bank. And I said, sir, you are the president of this bank, he said, by the grace of God. I said, I used to work in the bank when I was in Africa. He said, you did? He said, would you like to work in the bank here? I said, sure, I would. I would rather work in the bank than be delivering pizza. He said, come see me on Monday. And Monday morning, I was dressed up in my suit and in my tie. I removed the uniform of the pizza delivery guy. And I went to this man's office. And I was amazed the way he received me. I was amazed the way he introduced me to his vice president. He told him, he said, this is my friend. And I just knew him last Friday night. He said, fix him up. And that's how they got me that job. I didn't even sit for any interview. I didn't even write any exam. I didn't do any test. They just gave me the job. Of course, there is more to that story, which I will not want to go into for tonight. But the fact still remains that I was offered that job. The point I'm trying to make is this. Every single one of us can look into our lives and we can say, yeah, at this point, God connected me with somebody divinely. Why was it that I was the one that took the pizza there to deliver for him? Why wasn't it the next person, the next driver, the next employee that took the pizza to him? No, he wasn't divinely connected. God was divinely connecting me with someone to offer me a job. And I was the next one to go. And when I got there, it wasn't his wife that came out. That's still part of the divine arrangement. It wasn't any of his children that came out. That was still part of the divine arrangement. It was this man himself that came out. And why did he in the world give me his business card? Divine arrangement. My prayer for you is this. That God will consciously or unconsciously connect you with helpers in your life that will take you to the next level, that will bring about the answer to your prayers. In fact, I'm not even sure that Mary was praying for connection, but Jesus saw it. So my prayer for you is even the things that you have not prayed for, the Lord will see the need for it and give you the divine connection that you need. Your life can become different with divine connection. Your business can transform through divine connection. Your finances can change through divine connection. Your education can take off and be easier for you through divine connection. Your ministry can take off through divine connection. This is a fact that we see also in the Bible. God connects people to people to help fulfill his purposes in their lives. I think I have time. I got 2 more minutes to talk. I remember Elijah. There was a famine in the land. And the Bible says God commanded the ravens to feed Elijah by the brook. That's divine connection. God connected Elijah to the ravens. And the ravens brought him food, he ate the food, and he drank from the brook. But a time came when the brook dried up. Now that's the end of that divine connection. You know, sometimes God will give you a divine connection and it will dry up. That means that he's about to give you a better divine connection. So if your divine connection dries up, it's not time to cry. It's not time to say, God, what did I do wrong? It means that God is opening another door for you. It means that God is taking you to another level. It means God is talking to somebody else to be a blessing to you. And what did God do? God told Elijah, he said, you will need to go to Zarephath. There's a widow woman there. I have commanded her. You know, one of the prayers we're going to pray tonight, as God commanded the ravens to help Elijah, as God commanded the widow woman to help Elijah, so will God command all your helpers, wherever they may be, to rise up tonight and begin to help you. I have commanded. I want you to notice those words. Just like what Jesus did to John. I mean, Jesus wasn't asking John for a favor, my friends. Jesus was commanding John. He said, John, from now on, that's your mom. Mom, from now on, that's your son. And he never said beyond that. God commanded him and he did it. God commanded the ravens and they did it. God commanded the widow woman. In fact, do you know the widow woman was even reluctant to help at first? But because the commandment had been spoken by God, she had no choice but to agree to help Elijah. I want to say to you tonight, that if you can pray, God will raise up help for you in the areas where you need help. Have you ever seen a sick patient? getting a sloppy treatment, and someone just walks up to them and says, "Oh, why don't you go to Dr. So-and-so? I think he can help." And the chain doctors, they go to this new doctor, and the doctor knows exactly what the problem is. The doctor knows exactly what the solution is. Divine helper. And they get what they need. May God send you divine helper when you need it. I spoke to somebody in Africa today, and this person was telling me about a family member of hers. This is my cousin. And she told me about a family member of hers on her mother's side. I'm related to her on her father's side. And she told me, she said, this person had a heart attack right there in front of his house. Nobody was in the home. He was the only one who was just lying on the floor. And guess what happened? There was a man driving a Jeep that saw him laying down there, unable to move. He literally carried him and threw him into his Jeep and drove him to the next hospital. When he got there, he told them, "I don't know his name. I don't know anything about him. I just saw him laying down. I think he has a medical issue." Well, they said, "But we need you to give us some money." He paid them all the money they needed for his treatment. And then he told them the house where he picked him up at. And those people then went to their house and brought the children to the hospital. And they said, "Where is the man that took our daddy to the hospital?" The doctor said, "We don't know." "And what is his name?" They said, "We don't know." "Where did he say he came from?" They said, "We don't know." He was divinely connected to this guy, and he disappeared. And by the grace of God, the man is still alive up till today. The same God that did all this in the Bible, and the same God that did it and is still doing it in contemporary times, he will do it for you tonight, even as we go before God and ask him to connect us with helpers that can help us. Are you ready to pray tonight? I guess I am. I came here to pray, and I trust you came here to pray too. Let's go before him with thanksgiving. Let's go before him with praise. Let's say, "Lord, we thank you." Let's say, "Lord, we praise you." Let's say, "Lord, we glorify you. Lord, we honor you." You need helpers in your life, oh, that can help you and take you to the next level that you need to be, educationally, financially, maritally, etc., etc. I want you to say, "Lord, I thank you. I praise you. I worship you. Lord, I adore you, I honor you, and I bless your holy name. Thank you for bringing me to this place of prayer tonight. Thank you for bringing me to this place of intercession tonight. Thank you because you are not tired of listening to my voice. Thank you because you are not tired of hearing me. Father, I've come this evening. I've come to call on you this evening. I pray you will answer me this evening in the name of Jesus. I wanted to tell the Lord that the Lord will give you the strength to pray. The Lord will give you the power to pray. I want you to pray for me that the Lord will give me the grace to be able to lead this prayer myself, so that all of us, both who are leading and who are praying, we will all be able to focus on what we are here for tonight. And the Lord will open doors for us, send helpers to us. Maybe some of you need a surgeon to be sent to you. God can do it. Maybe some of you need someone that will give you a loan to be sent to you. Maybe some of you need somebody that will help you to take your business to the next level, connect you with contract, connect you with this, connect you with that, connect you with a school where you'll be able to do your medical program. The Lord can do anything by connecting us to the right people. I want you to just thank God and ask him to give you the grace to be able to focus, to give you the grace to be able to pray, to give you the grace to be able to seek him, and to give you the grace to be able to find him tonight. I want you to pray that if there be anything that will stand as a hindrance to you, if there be anything that will block you tonight, if there be anything that will block your prayers tonight, that the Lord in his mercy will remove from before you in the name of Jesus, that your prayer will be able to ascend unto him without any blockage, without any hindrance, without any barrier whatsoever, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray that you will touch me tonight. Touch me tonight to be able to pray without any blockage. If there be any sin of omission, any sin of commission, if there be any sin, any any transgression, any iniquity. I pray, Lord God, that you will wash us, you will cleanse us, you will purge us, you will purify us, O God, that we'll be able to get through to the throne of mercy in the name of Jesus without any blockage, to the throne of mercy without any hindrance, either personal hindrance or external hindrance. There will be no hindrance in this place tonight to any one of us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I want you to pray tonight that your faith will be strong. Even as you call down your helpers from the north, as you call your helpers from the south, as you call your helpers from the east and from the west, as you call your helpers from the country that you live in, as you call your helpers from outside the country that you live in, the Lord will do it for you in the name of Jesus. Do you need a lawyer tonight that can help you through your case? I remember I used to have a sloppy lawyer helping me with a situation many, many, many years ago. And God sent me this lady. I will never forget her. And she was the one that got through the case and everything worked out well. I want you to pray tonight that every helper you need tonight, the Lord will lose them wherever they are. The Lord will remove them from anything that is blocking them and blocking you from accessing them tonight. Father, just have your way tonight and strengthen us to pray. Strengthen us to pray. Strengthen us to call upon your name, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to make a confession tonight, and it will take humility in your on your part to make this confession. I want you to say, Father, say, I cannot make it without correct connection. Did you hear that? I cannot make it without correct connection. Say, my Father, don't leave me unconnected, O God. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and make that confession tonight. I cannot make it without correct connection, O God. In the name of Jesus, I admit it, O God. I confess it, O God. I need correct connection to be able to make it. I need correct connection to be able to survive. I need correct connection for this business to take off. I need correct connection for my health to go the way you want it to go, God. Father, I ask you tonight that you will not leave me unconnected in the name of Jesus. Father, make me a man and a woman that is connected to a divine helper in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to tell the Lord to deliver you from the pride of self-sufficiency. In the name of Jesus. You know, some people are so self-sufficient, they will never ask for help from anywhere. Some people are so self-sufficient, they will never look up to anybody for any help. I want you to pray tonight the Lord will deliver you from the pride of self-sufficiency. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, that you will look up unto the hills from whence cometh your help. Your help cometh from the Lord, who maketh the heavens and the earth. And 9 out of 10 times he will look at the earth and he will choose somebody to come to your aid. He will choose somebody to come and help you. I want you to pray tonight that you will never leave your world without helper, that the Lord will deliver you from the pride of self-sufficiency in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to say, oh my Lord, as you connected Mary with John, connect me with people that can meet my need, oh God. Come on, open your mouth and pray that prayer tonight, that as God connected Mary with John, God will connect you with people that can meet your need. God will connect you with people that will show you the way. God will connect you with people that will take care of your needs. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, we all have many needs in our lives, and we don't know the way out, we don't know the way in, but we know there are people that know the way out, know the way in. Father, I pray that you will connect us, O God, as you connected Mary with John. Connect me with people that can meet my need. In the story that I told you, there's no way I could have got a job in the bank, but God took me straight to the man in charge. I want you to pray tonight in the name of Jesus, that Father, take me to the people in charge in the name of Jesus. Father, take me to the people in charge in the name of Jesus. Take me to the people that can help me, O God. in the name of Jesus. As you connected Mary with John, connect me with the people that can meet my need. Connect me with the people that can help me, O God. Father, do it for me tonight in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that the anointing for connection, the anointing for divine connection to people, the anointing for divine connection to people. Oh God, Jesus Christ is so good. Jesus Christ hanging on the cross, he shouldn't have thought about connecting anybody. But you talk about mercy, you talk about compassion, you talk about forgetting himself and thinking about his mother. I want you to pray tonight that the Lord, the same compassion that he showed to Mary, he will show it to you tonight. He's a God full of mercy tonight, you know. He's a God full of compassion tonight, you know. I want you to pray that, oh Lord, the same mercy you showed to your mother, show to this mother that is praying to you tonight. I am another mother. I need help, oh God. In fact, history tells us that by this time, oh my God, the husband of Mary was dead. Joseph had already passed away. That's what Bible history tells us. And there was nobody, there was no helper. Daddy was gone, husband was gone. And now she needed a helper. And there are many people that are listening to us tonight and praying along with us. Your husband has walked away from you, either by death or by foolishness. Everybody is gone. You are the only one that is left. But you may be the only one that is left, but you got the God, the Ancient of Days, as your God. I want you to pray tonight. Say, my Father, my Father. I'm a woman like this woman called Mary tonight. I've got no helper. You are my only helper. Father, come down and connect me with somebody that will be a blessing to me, oh God. All the things that my husband used to do, I don't know how to do them. All the places my husband used to go, I don't know how to go there. All the responsibilities my husband used to carry, he has left everything for me in death. He has left everything for me because he died. He left everything for me because he divorced me. Whatever way he used to go, there is still a God in heaven that can give you connection. Connection of people that will come to help you, not because they want to sleep with you. People that want to help you, not because they want to destroy your life. People that want to help you, not because they want to get anything from you. I want you to pray tonight. Say, my Father, my Father, my Father. Ha! As you connected John and Mary, oh God, as you put Mary in the care of John, oh God, touch somebody's heart, oh God, to take care of me, oh God, to watch over me, oh God, to be my angel here on earth, oh God, because that's who John was to Mary. John was like an angel to Mary that took care of her. I want you to pray tonight, oh God, whoever you are, whether you are a man or a woman, you need an angel on your job that will show you the in and out of this job. You need an angel on your business to show you the in and out of this business. You need an angel in your life to show you the in and out of the country where you live. I want you to pray tonight, whoever that angel is, oh God, Father, speak to them and connect them to me tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I hope you are praying where you are tonight. I said, as John and Mary were connected by God, there was nothing sinful about it. It was just a help that was engineered by Jesus himself. I want you to pray, oh God, the compassion you showed to Mary, show it to me tonight in the name of Jesus. There are people listening to us, you have no parent, no father, no mother, only God, only God, only God. I want you to pray and tell the Lord, you are my only one, but you are my sufficient one. The person that has you has everything. The person that knows you knows everything. I pray that you will connect me like you connected your mother. I pray that you connect me like you connected Mary, oh God. Come on, open your mouth and pray wherever you are tonight. That as he connected Mary with John, he will connect you with people that can meet your need. He will connect you with people that will help you. He will connect you with people that will not help you and then be saying, hey, you see, I'm helping you. You see, I'm helping you. There will be people that will help you with all their heart and will not look back and give you an account. In the name of Jesus, Lord, you are still the same. The Bible says you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. As you connected Mary with John, John, oh God. Connect me with people on my job. Connect me with people in the headquarters of my office, oh God. Connect me with people in the home office where I am, oh God. And let them be of help to me, oh Holy Father. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and talk to the Lord tonight. That as he connected me with John, he will connect you with people that can meet your need tonight. Don't tell me you don't have any need. Don't tell me you are self-sufficient. There is nobody in this world that does not have need. We all need people to be connected to us so they can help us do this and help us do that. We are going to be on television in Guyana. It took connection for us to be able to be on television in Guyana. That's what I'm talking about, that being the right place, being with the right people, connected with the right people. I have never been in Guyana in my life, and yet we are on television in Guyana because of divine connection to help us. We are on television in Jamaica, not because we have been in Jamaica, but because there is divine connection. I said there is nobody that does not need connection in life. If you don't see, just pray to God that wherever I need a connection and I don't know it, wherever I need divine connection and I don't know it, wherever I need a helper and I don't know it, Father, open the door for me, O God. In the name of Jesus, open the door for me, O God. As you connected Elisha to Elijah, connect me with those that will take me to my destiny tonight. Open your mouth and pray where you are tonight, that as God connected Elijah to Elisha, he will connect you with those that will take you to your destiny tonight. Elisha will never have had the double portion if not for an Elijah in his life. That is divine connection. Why was it that it was Elisha that Elijah called and he said, follow me, leave what you are doing? And he followed him, connected to him, and at the end of the day, he got double portion measure of anointing. I want you to pray tonight, oh God, as you connected Elisha to Elijah, oh God, connect me with those that will take me to my destiny, oh God. Connect me to those that will make me fulfill why you have called me to the earth. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Come on, look at Joshua and Moses, my friends. I said, look at Joshua and Moses tonight. I want you to pray tonight and say, God, as you connected Joshua to Moses, connect me with helpers to destiny tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. As you connected Elisha to Elijah, as you connected Joshua to Moses, connect me with helpers to destiny tonight. Whatever you are selling, there are people who know how to sell it better than you. Whatever you are selling, there are people that know where you can get it cheaper to sell. I want you to pray for your business tonight. Father, connect me with those who know better. Connect me with those who know better. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Connect me with those who are higher in anointing. Connect me with those who are higher in wisdom. Connect me with those who are higher in knowledge. Connect me with mentors, not tormentors. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Who says he doesn't need help? Who says he doesn't need help? As long as you live here on earth, my friend, you will need a helper. Even after you die, you will still need a helper to put you in the grave. As long as you're on this earth, it is after you leave this world that you don't need a helper, dead or alive. You need a helper tonight. Father, send helpers into my life, like you send Elijah together, like you connected Joshua and Moses together. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let me hear you pray tonight. Let me hear you pray tonight. In the name of Jesus, wherever you may be tonight, let me hear your voice and call to God, that as God connected Joshua to Moses, he will connect you with the helpers to your destiny tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, I'm glad I'm hearing your voice tonight. I'm happy to hear your voice tonight. Come on, cry to God, cry to God, cry to God, cry to God. You will never be the same if you are connected. You will never be the same if you are connected. Father, connect me, oh God. I want to go far. If you want to go far, you need somebody to be connected with. If you want to go far, you need somebody that knows the road. If you want to go far in this business, if you want to go far in this profession, if you want to go far in this line of business, you need somebody who knows better than you tonight. Oh Lord, as you connected Joshua to Moses, Father God, connect me with helpers to destiny in my business. Connect me to helpers to in my spiritual life. I want you to pray tonight. Do you know that David will never have been easy for him to become king if not for Jonathan? God connected David to Jonathan and he was able to get on the throne. It was easier for him. Maybe he would have got on the throne anyway because God has spoken it, but it would have been a rougher road. I said it would have been a more dangerous road if not that God connected him with David. My friends, I want you to pray with all the fire in you tonight. The road to where you are going is not an easy road. There is a Saul waiting for you on the road. Did you hear what I said? There is an Ahab waiting for you on the road. Did you hear what I said? There is danger waiting for you on the road. There are serpents and scorpions waiting for you in the road. But there's somebody right now called Jonathan. He knows the road very well. He can navigate the palace for you very well. Can I ask you to pray with fire and thunder in your spirit that as God connected David to Jonathan, God will connect you with those that will make your journey to destiny easier for you. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Papa, as you connected them, oh God, connect me also to those that will help me in my journey. In the name of Jesus, as you connected David to Jonathan, as you connected Joshua to Moses, as you connected Elisha and Elijah, as you connected Mary and John, Father, I need my own connection tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, oh Lord, please arise, 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 arise. Take me to where you want me to get to. Take me to my destiny, oh Lord, by divine connection. Some of you have professions where it is dog eat dog. Did you hear what I said? You are in a profession where people are wicked. You are in a profession where people are mean. You are in a profession where people will walk on each other and trample each other to get where they are going. But God can give you somebody on that job, a divine helper on that job, a boss who doesn't even know you from Adam, will just take interest in you, not because of sin, but because God touches them, because God moves on them to help you. Say, my Father, as you connected David to Jonathan, I'm going into my palace, oh God. I need help to get to this palace in the name of Jesus. The palace that you are getting me into, the palace that you are taking me into, oh God. I confess tonight that I need help to be able to get there, oh God. You have already promised me, you have already prophesied it, you have already spoken it, but I need a divine helper. Father, connect me, connect me, connect me. Father, connect me, connect me, connect me. Father, connect me, connect me, connect me tonight. Where is my own Jonathan, oh God? In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Those of you who are widows on this prayer line tonight, those of you who are fatherless and motherless on this prayer line tonight, those of you who are helpless on this prayer line tonight, I want you to cry to God. There is hope for you. I'm saying this to you. You need to know that, my friend, that the Lord who looked upon widow woman called Mary and sent help immediately that day will send help to you also in the name of Jesus. Say, Father, I'm all alone, oh God. Father, I'm all alone, oh God. I don't have any money in the bank, oh God. I have to pay for this and pay for that and take care of this and take care of that. But I'm looking up to you tonight for divine connection, oh God. Connect me to somebody that will help me. Connect me to a group of people that will help me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. It's only if you doubt God, oh, if you will believe God, God will send people into your life in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, arise tonight. Oh Lord, arise tonight and send helpers into my life. Oh Lord, arise tonight and send helpers into my life. Divine connection, divine connection. People that will be touched to help me. I'll never forget one time I went to preach in a place, and the person I went to preach for walked up to me and gave me a check for $1,000. Yes, gave me a check for $1,000 and said, Bishop, there's somebody you know in Africa that is a widow, and this widow doesn't have anybody, but she has some boys and they need help. Can you take this $1,000 and send to them? I was shocked because I never preached about it. I never told her anything about it. And I know this widow woman needed help. Come and see what God did. They never talked together from that day. They never had any connection from that day. I was the bridge. I want you to pray tonight, divine connection. All of you that need money in your life, divine connection. All of you that need help in your life, divine connection. All of you that have no husband to help you, all of you that have no parents to help you, all of you that have husbands but your husband is powerless to help you, you are the one that is feeding him. If you understand what I'm saying, that is how sometimes life is. Your husband is unable to help you for one reason or for another, but God can bring somebody that will help both of you. God can bring somebody that will be connected to both of you to be able to help you and carry your load until everything is okay. I want you to pray for that divine connector tonight in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Come and open your mouth and tell the Lord, as you connected Mary to John, Father, connect me to my own John that will help me. Not because they want to sin with me, or not because they want to compromise with me, but because they feel touched by God to help me. Father, I will not choose for myself. I think that is where we make the mistake, people. We choose for ourselves. We look at people and we say, well, this one must have money, or this one must have this. We look at Judas Iscariot, who is a thief, and we say, well, Judas Iscariot is the richest among the disciples. But you don't know that Judas Iscariot is going to die very soon. And John was the one that lived longest. Did you hear what I said? I wouldn't have chosen John. I probably would have chosen Judas because he had money. But then what happened to Judas? He died in the next couple of days. And John lived to the book of Revelation. I want you to pray tonight. Father, deliver me from choosing for myself. Deliver me from choosing by myself. Father, choose helpers for me, O God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, connection, connection, connection. That's what you need to do. I'm telling you, connection, connection, divine connection. That's what you need tonight. Divine connection, divine connection. Father, divinely connect me on my job. Divinely connect me in my business. Divinely connect me in the government. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. There is no height that you cannot reach. If you are divinely connected, my friend, there is no height that you cannot get to. If you are divinely connected, my friend, pray for that divine connection tonight. Pray for that divine connection tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, arise, arise and speak to my John and connect them with me, O God. Arise and speak to my Moses and connect them with this Joshua, O God. Arise, O God, and speak to my Jonathan and connect them with this David, O God. Can I ask you to pray that God will begin to move for you from tonight? Move people into your life from the north. Move people into your life from the south. Move people into your life from the east. Move people into your life from the west that will elevate you in life, that will help you in life. Move people into your life from the headquarters. Move people into your life from the home office. People that know. Did you hear what I said? people that know, Papa, move them into my life, oh Lord, to take me to my destiny, oh God, to take me to my next level, oh God. Move people into my life from the north, move people into my life from the south, move people into my life from the east and to the west, to help elevate me, oh God, like you did it for Mary, oh Jesus. You did it for Mary on a day that he did not expect. Did you hear that? Mary wasn't expecting anything like that day. I want you to pray on a day that I don't expect. Connect me with my helpers in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. On any regular day, oh God, that I thought everything would be regular, let things change for me forever by connection in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let me just ride in the train and by accident or by divine interposition, sitting beside a man or a woman that will just say one or two things that will show me the way, or riding in a cab, or riding in a bus, or riding in a taxi, or riding in an airplane. Father, connection, connection, connection. Father, connect me with people from the north, connect me with people from the south, connect me with people from the east, connect me with people from the west. Oh Lord, when I least expect, Lord, connect me with people in the name of Jesus, like you did for Mary at a time when she never expected it. Father, when I least expect connection, Father, connect me to the right people. I want you to open your mouth and tell God, I want the right people in the name of Jesus. I don't want sharks in my life, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I don't want crocodiles in my life, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I don't want snakes and serpents in my life, oh God. I don't want scorpions in my life, oh God. Connect me with the right people, oh God, like you did for Mary in places where she least expected. That was the least place she was expecting a connection, because in real fact, people, Jesus was hanging on the cross now, and yet Jesus had time for him, for her, and connected her. I want you to pray in the name of Jesus, the time I least expect, the place I least expect, the one I least expect. Father, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it. Let my connection be triggered at a place that I least expect, in the name of Jesus. Let divine connection be triggered at a time that I least expect, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I said, like you did for Mary tonight, in places where I least expect, connect me with contracts, connect me with contracts, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I'm not looking for wrong connection. I've had enough of that in my life. I've had enough of time wasters in my life. I need mentors, not tormentors. I've had enough of tormentors in my life. They wasted my time and wasted my money and wasted my talent only to walk away from me, oh God. Father, now I give it to you. I give it to you. Take care of it, oh God. Take care of that area for me, oh God. I want you to tell the Lord to break the cord. To break the cord of wrong connection in your life. Every cord of wrong connection in your life. Command the Lord to break it for you in the name of Jesus. Every cord of wrong connection in your life. Tell the Lord to break them for you tonight. Father, come into my life tonight. Everyone I'm wrongly connected to that I think is my savior, that I think is my helper. Father, come down and break that cord. Father, come down and break that connection. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Father, break every connection that is not from heaven. Break every connection that is not from heaven. Send me connection that is from heaven, O Lord. Any cord of wrong connection in my life, Father, I give you the permission to break them. I give you the permission to block them. I give you the permission to destroy them. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. The reason I'm laughing is sometimes times. It may be your lawyer that is a wrong connection. Have you ever seen the lawyer working for you, but is also working for the other party at the same time? Oh my Lord, people are wicked. I want you to pray tonight. Those that are working for you and working for your enemies at the same time. Those that you think you are telling all your secret to, and they are leaking your secret to other people. Those are wrong connections, my friend. Father, break the connection in the name of Jesus. Break the connection, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Every cord, every tie, every chain that ties me to wrong people, that ties me to wrong connections. Father, disconnect tonight. Father, disconnect tonight. Father, disconnect tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Can I ask you to pray for total strangers to begin to show you favor in the name of Jesus. Yes, total strangers. Let them begin to show me favor from tonight in the name of Jesus. People who have never met me before, people who have never known me before, people who just look at me and take interest in my case, people who just look at me and want to help my children. Can I ask you to pray for your children wherever they may be tonight? They are no more under your care. You used to be the one showing them favor. Now they are scattered all over the world. I want you to pray for them wherever my sons are tonight, wherever my daughters are tonight. Father, send people to show them favor in the name of Jesus. After all, you have shown favor to people before. You have shown favor to strangers before. Hey, it's time for your children to reap what you have sowed now. God, wherever my children are tonight, wherever my sons are tonight, wherever my daughters are tonight, let favor begin to follow them in the name of Jesus with good connections. Let favor begin to follow them with great connections in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Mary was at the right place at the right time. Did you hear what I said? I said Mary was at the right place at the right time. Say, my Father, direct my steps, O God. Guide my steps, O God. Let me be at the right place at the right time. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Come on, open your mouth and tell the Lord. She was at the cross, at the right place, at the right time. Say, Lord, let me always be at the right place, at the right time, with the right helpers. In the name of Jesus. Did you hear the three things I said? That I will always be at the right place, at the right time, with the right helpers. In the name of Jesus. I wish some people were on this prayer line tonight, because God is going to plant something for you. God is going to deposit something in your life. In the name of Jesus. If somebody is not on this prayer line tonight, make sure you tell them to listen to the podcast at the right place, at the right time, with the right helpers. Come on, pray those three prayers together tonight. Father, I pray that you will put me at the right place, at the right time, with the right helpers. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, oh God, begin to move upon the hearts of the right people. Can I ask you to pray that prayer, that the Lord will help you, that the Lord will move upon the hearts of the right people, that will take you to the next level on your job, that will take you to the next level in your profession, that will take you to the next level in your ministry. The Lord will begin to move upon the hearts of the right people to help take you to the next level. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it for me. Father, do it, do it, do it, do it, do it for me. Move on the hearts of the right people to help me take me to the next level, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. All the vacuum in my life, that was what John filled for Mary. There was a vacuum of a helper in her life. Do you know God knows there is a vacuum in your life? Oh yes, he does. I want you to tell the Lord, say Lord, I know you know there is a vacuum in my life. I know you know there is a vacancy for a helper in my life. Send my John to fill that vacancy in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Send my helper to fill that vacancy in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. But I know I have to be at the right place, at the right time, with the right people at the right place at the right time with the right people. I said at the right place. I said at the right time. I said at the right time. I said at the right time. I want you to pray tonight that the Lord will not allow you to miss God's timing. You will not miss divine timing for your life. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, send help us to the people that are praying here tonight. Father, send help us to the people that are calling on you tonight. Even me who is leading this prayer tonight, send help us to me also in every area that I need a helper in the name of Jesus. Father, begin to move upon the hearts of the right people. We don't want the wrong people. Begin to move upon the hearts of the right people that will take us to the next level in life in the name of Jesus. Experts, experts, experts. Can I ask you to pray concerning that? God will bring experts into your life in the field where you need help. God will bring helpers into your life in the area where you need help. God will bring experts into your life in the field where you need help. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. There are helpers who can help you with your health. There are helpers who can help you with your children. There are helpers who can help you with the causes that your children are having difficulty with. Can you ask God to send helpers to them in the name of Jesus? Expert in the field where you are short. Experts in the field where you are short. That the Lord will send you helpers in the name of Jesus. Do you know what happened today? Mary was not in need at that time. It was the need of tomorrow that Jesus took care of that time. Can I ask you to pray tonight that like Mary, your tomorrow helpers will be selected for you today. Your tomorrow helpers will be selected for you today at that spot, at that time. Mary did not need any helper, but it was from after that day that she would need the helper. I want you to pray tonight, oh, the helpers I will need tomorrow. Papa, select them for me today. Oh, don't wait till tomorrow to select them for me. Oh, don't wait till it is too late to select them for me. Oh, like Mary, let my tomorrow helpers be selected for me today in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I guess Jesus looked into the future. Did you hear what I said? I guess Jesus looked into the future and he said, Mama, Mama, you are going to need help. So I'm going to help you now to find a helper. I wanted to say, my Father, my Father, my Father, look into my future needs. Papa, please look into my future needs and send me ready-made helpers in the name of Jesus. John was ready-made. Hallelujah. I said John was ready-made. I want you to pray tonight in the name of Jesus. Look into my future needs, oh God. Send me ready-made helpers, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Send me helpers that you have blessed to help. Send me helpers that you have anointed to help. Send me helpers that you have enabled to help in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Can I ask you to pray another prayer tonight? You know the ravens and the brook. The brook dried up. The brook dried up. Maybe your previous helpers dried up. And you are crying and you are wondering and you are having sleepless night. If you are a child of God, there is no need to worry, my friend. If you are a child of God, there is no need to worry, my friend. When one door closes, God opens a better door. I want you to pray tonight. Say, my Father, I am like Elijah tonight. The brook has dried up. My helper has dried up. Open another door for me, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Another door that will be better than the door of what dried up. Now he doesn't have to sleep by the brook. Now he can sleep inside the house. In the name of Jesus, the former helper, it was a bird, a raven for that matter, that brought the food. But now it was a woman and her baby that brought the food, a better condition. Can I ask you to pray this tonight? Lord, give me better condition. Father, you see my condition. Give me a better condition than I used to have. I thank you for the one that helped me and walked away. I thank you for the one that helped me and dried up. But I want a better helper, oh God. I want a better condition, oh God. Father, arise in your mercy. Father, arise. arise in your mercy. Father, arise in your mercy in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight. I want you to pray tonight. Papa, look into my future needs and send me ready helpers tonight in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Did you know that Mary never suffered in life because she was connected with a compassionate connection? I want you to pray tonight. Oh Lord, as Mary never suffered in life, let me be connected with compassionate helpers. In the name of Jesus, help us that will fight my suffering on God's behalf. Help us, oh God, that are full of mercy. Help us, oh God, that are full of compassion, that will fight me, that will fight my suffering, and that will not fight me, but will fight my suffering on your behalf. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, if you are suffering tonight because of lack of helper, say, Lord, you are the helper of the helpless. Oh, you are the helper of those who suffer. You are the helper of those who do without. Father, arise, help me, oh God. Let me not find helpers when it is too late. Can I ask you to pray that prayer, that the Lord will not allow you to find a helper when it is too late, in the name of Jesus, when the bottom has dropped out, in the name of Jesus, when the help will now come and it is too late. Father, don't let that be my portion. Let me not find helpers when it is too late, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Can I ask you to pray for another prayer, especially in this world that we are living in? You know, some people will go to your helpers, some people will fight your helpers, some people will accuse your helpers of this and accuse your helpers of that, and some people will talk your helpers out of helping you. I want you to pray tonight that let my helpers be those that cannot be talked out of helping, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let my helpers be those who cannot be talked out of helping. Let my helpers be those that cannot be manipulated out of helping. Let my helpers not be those, oh God, that will be bullied out of helping me, oh God. Nobody could talk John out of it. Nobody could talk John out of it. Nobody could talk Jonathan out of helping David. Even his daddy tried it, but it did not help. It did not work. I want you to pray that God will divinely connect you with helpers that cannot be talked out, helpers that cannot be bullied out, helpers that cannot be shamed out, helpers that cannot be accused falsely out, in the name of Jesus. Father, let my helpers be those that cannot be talked out of helping me, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Can I ask you to pray for helpers tonight, that God will send you helpers, that God will send you helpers that will look for nothing in return? Did you hear that? Help us that will look for nothing in return, in the name of Jesus. There are people that will help you simply because they want to get something from you. But Mary had nothing to offer anybody. But God said, John is not going to look for anything from my mother. All John will do is help my mother. I want you to pray in this present world that we live in, that God will raise Johns up for you. People that will help you without asking you for any favor. People that will help you without asking you for sin, people that will help you without asking you for compromise. Father, arise, put my interest in John, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Speak to the heart of John tonight. Whoever that John is, I don't know, oh God, help us that we look for nothing in return, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I feel we need to pray for our children tonight, in their schools, in their place of work, that God will send helpers to them, in the name of Jesus. Pray for your children tonight, wherever they go in life. Oh God, send helpers to them, in the name of Jesus. Wherever my children go in life, oh God, send helpers to them, oh God, in this world of selfish pursuits. Send helpers that will help them, oh God. Send helpers that will elevate my children, oh God. Many of them are in fields that you don't know anything about. You will have helped them if you did. Many of them are in areas that you don't have any expertise, but God does, and God can speak to them in the name of Jesus and send helpers to them. I want you to mention the name of your children wherever they are tonight. I want you to mention the name of your grandchildren wherever they are tonight. Say, Father, wherever my children are, Father, wherever my grandchildren are, send helpers to them, oh God, in this selfish world. In the name of Jesus, let somebody arise and take up their case as if they are their brother, as if that they are mother, as if that they are their father. Father, rise up, rise up, rise up, rise up, rise up, rise up, rise up. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the corporate world where they are, send helpers to them that will help to elevate them in the name of Jesus. In the business world where they are, send helpers to them that will help to elevate them in the name of Jesus. In the academic life where our children are tonight, send them, oh Lord, helpers that will help them in the academics, that will help them to be the head, that will help them not to be the tail. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray for your children tonight in all of life's undertakings. Connect them with their helpers, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in their undertakings in life, in their undertakings in life, connect them with helpers, oh God. You know, if you were there and you knew how to, you will help them. Unfortunately, you are not there and you cannot help them, but there are people there. There are people like John there. There are people like Jonathan there. There are people like Moses there. God will connect them with all these people, and they will be able to help your children to next level of elevation. In the name of Jesus, pray for your children in all of life's undertakings, oh God. Connect them with their helpers. Connect them with their helpers. Connect them with their helpers that will help take them to the next level in life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we release our children to you tonight. Father, be their helper, oh God. Day and night, be their helper, oh God. In the name of Jesus, whatever they need, oh God, send angels of mercy to them. In the name of Jesus, send angels of mercy to them, that they will be able to write home and call home and say, Mommy, Daddy, can you believe this? This is what happened. That is what happened. Father, arise and help us, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Let's pray for our spiritual life tonight. Many of us need help in our spiritual life. I want you to pray tonight. Say, my Father, my Father, my Father. In my spiritual life, please, as Priscilla and Aquila were connected to Apollos, let me be connected with those that will help my faith, oh God. As Priscilla and Aquila were connected to Apollos and they helped, Father, let me be connected with people that will help me, oh God. Apollos was a man that was mighty in scriptures. Apollos was a man that was mighty in faith, but he still needed help. Who out of us does not need help? Even me, who is leading this prayer, I need help. I need a Priscilla. I need an Aquila. Oh God, connect us with people that will spiritually take us to the next level and help us to be humble enough. Many of us, once we know how to say ABC in the faith, we feel we don't need Priscilla and Aquila. But Apollos humbled himself and got help from Aquila and Priscilla. I want you to pray tonight. God will send you your Priscilla. God will send you your Aquila. God will send you your Priscilla. God will send you your Aquila that will help you in the name of Jesus in matters connected to your faith, that will take you to the next level in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Can I ask you tonight that the Lord will send helpers? Helpers that will raise up. God will raise people up. Not helpers that are looking for money, you know. There are helpers in the spirit that all they want is your money. Before they go and pray for you, they ask you to send prayer money. Before they fast for you, they ask you to send fasting money. God didn't sell those people to you. Greed send those people to you. I want you to pray tonight and tell the Lord, Father, send me, send me, send me. Send me Priscillas and Aquilas. Connect me with people who are spiritually minded, that I will be connect with to lead lead me to a next level in my faith, to lead me to my next level in walking with you. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I want you to pray tonight concerning the Samaritan. Do you remember that Samaritan man that was connected to the man that was injured by thieves on Jerusalem to Jericho Road? I want you to pray that God will send you helpers to help ease your pains in life. Many of us have pains in life. Oh, Lord, have mercy. I said many of us have pains in life. And God just sent a Samaritan. There was a priest that went by there. There was a Levite that went back there. I'm saying to you, oh, the people you think will help you, they are not your helpers. Oh, let God send you the real helpers. Father, as the Samaritan was connected to the man that was injured between Jerusalem and Jericho tonight, Father, send me helpers to help ease my pains in life, to help ease my injuries in life. Many of us are injured physically. Many of us are injured spiritually. Many of us are injured emotionally. And we need helpers to heal us. We need helpers to point us to place of help. Father, send them. Father, send them. Father, send them. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want us to pray tonight about the widow woman again. Oh, the widow woman. Oh, hey. After God spoke to the widow woman and said, you are to feed Elijah, you know what the widow woman said? The widow woman said to Elijah, no, I don't have anything to do with you. I cannot feed you. She was reluctant. I want you to pray. Reluctant helpers, the Lord will walk on them in the name of Jesus. All helpers that God has already spoken to, all helpers that God has already ministered to, all helpers that God has already commanded, but they are very, very reluctant. They are dragging their feet. I want you to pray tonight. Minister to them as I'm praying right now. Minister to my helpers as I'm praying right now. If they have been hardened against me, Father, soften them towards me. If they have been hardened against me, Father, soften them towards me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. All reluctant helpers. All reluctant helpers that you have already connected me to, but they are flouting your command. They are kicking against your command. They are afraid of obeying your command. Father, every reluctant helper, oh God, Father, speak to them, speak to them, speak to them. In the name of Jesus, speak to them, speak to them, speak to them. In the name of Jesus, speak to them, speak to them, speak to them, that they will not be reluctant, oh Lord. Father, remove every reluctance from them in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord. You know the help that the widow got from Elijah was a long-lasting help. I want you to pray tonight. Enough of 3 months' help, enough of 1 month help, enough of 1 year help. I want you to pray that long-lasting helps. The Lord will send helpers like that into your life. Help us, oh God, that will help me for long. Father, send them to me, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Not helpers that will help for a while, and in the process use me and dump me. In the name of Jesus, send me godly helpers. Send me helpers that fear God, oh God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Can I ask you to pray another prayer tonight? As the sun helped Joshua, as the moon helped Joshua. Do you remember that was a divine connection also? The sun helped Joshua, the moon helped Joshua on the day of battle. I want you to pray that natural element in the name of Jesus will help me to always overcome. I don't know what you are fighting against right now, but God will send you natural elements, the sun and the moon, to help you in the name of Jesus. Maybe it's some medication you need for this your problem. Oh, maybe it's your medication. The medication is just $5, oh, and you don't know about it. Oh, but the Lord can connect you with that medication. Oh, in the mighty name of Jesus, whatever natural element God wants to use to help you, may God connect you with that natural element in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I will never, never, never forget when Hezekiah was sick and God said he was going to die. It was a simple olive tree. Olive tree, olive leaf. They put on the boil, they put on the wound, and Hezekiah was made whole. I want you to pray tonight. Please pray tonight in the name of Jesus. Whatever it will take, oh Lord, whatever natural remedy is out there for me, oh God, I've used every medication in the book. I've taken every shot in the hospital. I've taken every injection in the hospital. There must be a solution somewhere. There must be a solution somewhere. Can you open your mouth and pray with thunder tonight? Connect me with the solution, oh God, to my problem. Connect me with the solution to my problem, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Connect me with the solution to my problem, oh God. Papa, connect me with the solution, solution, solution. Open your mouth and pray tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Connect me with the solution. Oh, I don't know the solution to this issue. I don't know the solution to this problem. Connect me with the solution in the name of Jesus. Connect me with the solution. In the name of Jesus, connect me with a solution, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, connect me with a solution, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. My time is up, oh, my time is up. My time is up, my time is up. But I have to pray, we have to pray this prayer before we leave tonight. Do you know that John was the one that lived longest among the disciples? Yes, John lived the longest of all the apostles. I want you to pray tonight. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, my divinely appointed helpers will not die while I need them. Open your mouth and fire prayer tonight. Father God, we come before you tonight. I pray for my divine helpers that you will send to me, oh God. John lived longest. He lived beyond Mary, I believe. My divinely appointed helpers, they will not die while I need them in the name of Jesus. They will not die while I need them in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for the divine helpers that are present in my life. I pray for the divine helpers that you will send to my life. Father, let them live long and long and long and long and long. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Yes, 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 yes. My divine helpers, let them not die while I need them, oh God. Let them not die while I depend on their help, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, compensate them with good health. Compensate them with long life. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I want you to pray that God will help them to help you. To where you become independent yourself. Did you hear what I said? That you will not have to depend upon them for life. You will have to be able to stand on your own. The Lord will make it possible in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Finally, I want us to pray against coronavirus. Oh, I want you to say, my Father, send into our world. Help us to put an end to coronavirus. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray tonight for the last prayer that the Lord will send our world, that the Lord will send our cities, that the Lord will send our countries, that the Lord will send our world. Help us to put an end to this virus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, send help us, oh God. Send help us, oh God, that will help put an end to this virus, oh God. Whether through medication, whether through vaccine, whichever way they do it. Father, put an end to this virus. Everybody is saying there is no end in sight, but we know with you all things are possible. Send help to us, oh God, to put an end to this pandemic, oh God. In the name of the Father. In the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. And everybody said amen. Everybody said amen. Everybody said amen. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Father God, we thank you because you love us. We thank you because you care for us. We thank you because you never leave us alone. You never forsake us. We cannot live without divinely appointed helpers. Even when Noah needed to build an ark, he needed helpers. You could have built the ark for him, but you sent helpers to him. Father, in any way, in any form, in any shape, where we are helpless, where we are clueless, where we don't know the right from the left, where we don't know where to go next, there are helpers out there that you can touch. Papa, as a result of this prayer tonight, touch them and bring them in from the north. Bring them in from the south. Bring them in from the east. Bring them in from the west. There are areas where we need help, but we don't see it. Because many of us are praying this prayer. We are just praying. We don't feel we need any help from anywhere. Father, even where we don't know we need help, still send the helpers to us. In the mighty name of Jesus. Even where we have not prayed for helpers. Father, send the helpers tonight and let us see clearly that we need help. And Father, as they come, let them not die where they are helping us. Let them not give up where they are helping us. Let them not have problems that will stop the help. In the name of Jesus Christ. And we pray also for ourselves that in our own little way, you will help us to help others too. You will help us to reach out to others in our own little ways in the mighty name of Jesus. Help us to never fail in your calling for us to be a help to other people. Father, we bless you tonight. We open the door for the helpers. Let them come from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west. And let our lives be bettered by it from today. We thank you for the answer. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name, we pray. Amen. And amen. And amen.
All participants are muted. And they can amen. Unmute themselves.
Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Those of you who are calling in and those of you who are listening to us on the podcast, may God bless you. May you begin to experience help from the right, from the left, from the front, from the back. From today on, in the name of Jesus. One or two announcements before I turn you loose tonight, please. Sunday morning at 9:30, we have Sunday school on Zoom. We're still looking for some of you in that Sunday school. Please join us 9:30 on Sunday morning. And I got a word for you. On Sunday morning at 10:30 on YouTube, on Facebook, and on my podcast. Don't miss my sermon on Sunday morning. You want me to tell you what the title is? Yes, I will. 10 things that God cannot do. I know you know. I know you believe that with God all things are possible. And that is true. But even though with God all things are possible, I have identified 10 things that are not possible with God. What are those 10 things? You have to tune us in on Sunday morning on YouTube and on Facebook and on Spreaker. And if you are able to be on my, if you're one of those that follow me on my Twitter, I'm sure that my friends who help me with the Twitter, those are my own helpers, divinely appointed helpers, they will be there to give you the link also if you want to connect through Twitter. Friends in Metro Manila and provinces in the Philippines, I'll be with you on Sunday morning at 10 a.m. I will start preaching at 10 a.m. prompt on Sunday morning. Please don't miss it. I got a word for you that I think will bless you. And Sunday at 6 p.m., don't forget on Zoom graduation program. We want to honor all our graduating seniors, regardless of their level of education. It promises to be a beautiful time. That is on Zoom at 6 p.m. We would like to know how this prayer line has been a blessing to you and how this podcast has been a blessing to you. Please drop us a note at bishop@deliveranceplace.com. bishop@deliveranceplace.com. I will have given you the address of the freshanointing.org, but it takes so long for emails to get to that thing. I don't know why that is so. But this one for Deliverance Place, the moment you say send, we will receive it. That's bishop@deliveranceplace.com. We'd like to hear from you. We'd like to hear your testimonies. And we'd like to hear how these prayers and how this podcast and prayer line has been a blessing to you. Thank you so much for listening tonight. Please don't forget, after we say the grace, to go to www.freshanointing.org/giveonline. We need your help. I keep saying it. We need your help. And you know we do. And we know you need God's help too. As you help the work of God, I believe God will help your work also. Shall we share the grace and fellowship before we leave this place tonight?
All participants are unmuted.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen and amen and amen and amen. Thank you so much for listening, for praying. I pray that God will give you a peaceful night rest until Sunday morning when we meet again. This is Bishop signing off and saying, please stay safe. Bye-bye.